Hello there, my music lovers. I'm George from Audiophile Heaven, and today we are having a look at something that deserves respect. This is the Sivga Phoenix. This is like a bird that could die and come back to life, or rather it is a really good headphone, so let's dig right into it. The Sivga Phoenix comes in a pretty largish package. I consider this to be fairly large. And they are actually one of the best accessorized headphones in the world, at least from what I've experienced so far. They are priced at $250, being one of the most affordable headphones in the entire world. I mean, there are affordable headphones out there, I reviewed ones that are much cheaper, but none that is quite as good as the Sivga Phoenix at this price point. So inside the package is just this carrying case, which is useful, not the best shape actually. It is very old style looking. It also doesn't really offer portability. You just have to take this and place it in a bag. It's not a backpack, it's not anything else, but it offers excellent protection to the Sivga Phoenix. They resist. So yeah, it is a pretty good way of protecting your Sivga Phoenix. Inside the package, we can find the headphones. And there was this little pouch, which came with accessories, the cable, and one adapter from 3.5 mm to 6.3 mm both single ended. Taking out the Sivga Phoenix, we are met with a headphone made of metal, leather and wood. This is one of the most interesting headphones I've tested lately. I am sorry if I sound quite a bit weird, but for me it's been weeks since I filmed the last video, so. The size adjusting mechanism is actually pretty rigid and works quite well. They are able to fit my head, but I'm not sure if they would fit a much larger head. So this is pretty much the limit of what they would fit. The ear pads are actually quite spacious inside, despite not looking as such. They can fit my ears and they would still have some wiggle space. So even if you have larger ears, the Sivga Phoenix should be quite all right. The headphone swivel in this direction. It is not a big swivel, but it should be enough for them to adjust to most head sizes and shapes out there. The headphones are made of leather on the outside and fine textile material on the inside. They are extremely comfortable, very thick, very comfortable actually. I love the pads of the Sivga Phoenix. They are a dynamic driver headphone, so this is not a planar magnetic headphone. They are very easy to drive compared to Hifiman Sundara, but they are much harder to drive than headphones typically priced at $250, so they are okay to drive. You will need a good smartphone, because for example my Xiaomi Poco F2 Pro is able to drive them perfectly at maximum volume. They get no distortion from it, but they feel a bit constrained and a bit limited from the Poco phone, so they could take more power without distortion, which means that they have extremely low distortion. So they sound excellent at low, medium and high volumes. Everything sounds just excellent through the Sivga Phoenix. They are comfortable for the most part, they leak a lot, so this is a very open back headphone. They also don't really isolate from the outside noise. You will hear pretty much everything that is going on around you, so don't expect any type of passive noise isolation. They are very fashionable, so if you want to annoy those around you, you should choose a fashionable headphone. Like, go out, listen to some loud music, annoy everyone, but do it in style. Don't do it with an ugly headphone. The Sivga Phoenix is a great way to do it. It is a smallish and portable headphone. I love that about them. They are very good for long-term portability. And I noticed this, but the cups are not equally thick all around. So they are trying to follow the shape of the human head and the human ear so that they can be as comfortable as possible. To their advantage, they managed to do that quite well. They are extremely comfortable for me, for my ears, for my experience. They are excellent in pretty much everything. I would put this on my head just because they feel so good. There is no driver flex, no inherent issues, nothing that I can mention that I'm unhappy about. Almost nothing actually. The cable that comes with the Sivga Phoenix is not the same as the one they included with their Sivga P2. And this cable is much more flexible, very slightly tangle prone, so almost no tangle prone, but it has a pretty big disadvantage. It is quite thin. I do not really trust this cable as much as I trusted the one that came with the Sivga P2. This one is ended in a 3.5 mm single-ended jack, so you won't be able to use it with balanced sources. And once again, this cable, just like the one for the Sivga P2, ends in a mini type of jack. So cables from Hifiman Sundara or Harmonic Dyne Zeus or Meze 99 Classics are not going to be compatible with this cable for the Sigva Phoenix. Basically, I don't really know any other headphone that uses the same cable, so you are going to be out of luck if you decide to go for them, and if you want to exchange the cable, you need to have custom cables made for them because they use this mini type of jack. In terms of sound, the Sigva Phoenix is probably the best sounding $250 headphone you can get. It matches my taste so perfectly that I have absolutely no second thoughts about recommending them. They are just that great. The bass is somewhat hard, it is somewhat solid, it has a beautiful kind of rumble. It doesn't really have a lot of thump, so it doesn't thump you. It basically rumbles. It is very good with the sublows expansion, beautiful sub bass. It is excellent, and I mean absolutely excellent, outstanding when it comes to definition. The mid-range has beautiful detail, very good soundstage. It is well-rounded, both depth and width are excellent. They have excellent instrument separation, excellent resolution, beautiful detailing on instruments and textures and details and micro details. The treble is sparkly, has an excellent extension. You can hear every single cymbal crash. You can hear everything just so nicely. The treble is one of those that is not one bit sibilant. They are not one bit harsh, so you can listen to some pretty hardcore music without ever feeling fatigued or tired, but they still are engaging and fun. And this is the best thing about them. They are very well balanced. And when it comes to listening to very energetic music, I loved doing it with the Sigva Phoenix. They are just so nicely done. I actually spent a ton of time thinking whether I have any complaints about the Sigva Phoenix, and quite honestly, I have none. There is absolutely nothing I can say bad about them. There is nothing I can complain about. They are just perfect. Just like the Harmonic Dynzios is pretty much perfect, besides the default cable, because the Harmonic Dynzios had a terrible cable. I don't even know how it went out of design while having that cable. The Sigva Phoenix is the same. A perfect headphone, a somewhat bendy, somewhat kinda not such a great default cable, but otherwise excellent. They are a very recommended headphone by me, George from Audiophile Heaven. For our two comparisons, I prefer the Sigva Phoenix over the Sigva P2. The Sigva P2 has a very specific sound. They do a boop kind of sound where they kind of push it into you. They are very thumpy, but very thumpy in the upper bass. So the Sigva P2 was quite colored for me. They are extremely warm in the mid-range and they have an interesting treble. The Sigva P2 was a unique player. They were good, but the Sigva Phoenix is much more general. They are much more natural in the mid-range. They have a beautiful presentation that works well with both male and female voices, rock, metal, classical, jazz, pretty much everything. The Sigva Phoenix is a very good generalist headphone. In fact, if you have just $250, those are the most recommended headphones I can recommend you right now. So they are above the 99 Classics from Meze. They are above them in terms of definition. How natural the bass is actually, because the bass of the 99 Classics is much larger, but at the same time it is a bit unnatural. It is a bit too thick. It tends to darken the sound a bit too much, while the Sigva Phoenix sounds natural. They sound beautiful. They sound just so damn enjoyable. The only other headphone that was worthy of mention was the Ultrason DJ1 Pro in about this price range. But the Ultrason DJ1 Pro is actually not really widely available, and they had a terrible build quality, and I used that headphone. I loved the DJ1 Pro, but the DJ1 Pro died in my hands. They started by peeling off. Everything about that headphone was peeling off. The Sigva Phoenix actually survived quite a few weeks of usage without any single trace of usage, and I'm going to be updating in the comments whether they will start to peel off, whether they will start to break down, and whether they will start to show the usage. One headphone that many of you guys asked me to compare the Sigva Phoenix with is the Hifiman HE-A400, and that is an excellent comparison. The Sigva Phoenix is actually warmer than the HE-A400, it is more detailed in the mid-range, it also has a deeper, more solid bass. On the other hand, the HE-A400 is colder, brighter. They present music much wider than the Sigva Phoenix, and while the Sigva Phoenix is quite holographic, the HE-A400 is better in that aspect, so the soundstage is better on the HE-A400. I prefer the overall natural, warmish kind of mid-range of the Sigva Phoenix over the colder, brighter presentation of the HE-A400 for most music. The only music style where I prefer the HE-A400 from Hifiman is metal. And with metal, I actually prefer the HE-A400i and other HE-A400 releases for pop, for EDM, for dubstep. I actually prefer the Sigma Phoenix. They're deeper, more rounded bass, fuller sound with more body, actually works better for those music styles. But I really love the Here 402, and they are more comfortable. They are a larger headphone, less portable, actually kind of cheaper than the Sigma Phoenix. And I do think that if you need a very portable headphone, you will go for the Sigma Phoenix. Also, the Here 400i and other Here 400 variations look much worse than the Sigma Phoenix. And the Sigma Phoenix is a truly stunning headphone. This is how a beautiful headphone should look like. The Here 400 looks a bit industrial, it looks a bit too metallic, the metallic meshes don't really work for everyone. And while I do love the Here 400i, especially the 2020 version, I do consider the Sigma Phoenix to be a better contender for the best headphone I've seen in terms of overall balance. They are very well priced, the price performance ratio is excellent, they have a very natural general sound. I do not know any other headphone that I would recommend more in this style. So open back, kind of portably, and at $250 price range, because the higher we climb on the price range, the better I can recommend more headphones. And I know many other headphones I would recommend to you. But if you are constrained by the price, the Sigma Phoenix is good. Also, please keep in mind, I do recommend this one from Amazon. You get excellent coverage, excellent shipping, very quick. You get excellent warranty from Amazon. They actually fulfill their warranty very well. And this is a very short story, but once I ordered from them an SSD, and the SSD actually got delayed quite a bit, about a month. And I contacted Amazon, told them that my SSD is delayed. And what happened? They told me that they don't know. They kind of lost the shipping, and they sent me another. So I received the one they sent me the second time because they used better shipping, and I also received the original SSD I ordered after another 2 or 3 weeks. So both of them arrived, and I contacted Amazon. I told them about it, and they told me that it's okay to keep both. It is their mistake, and they are going to take responsibility for it. So I was kind of happy with the service of the Amazon. Don't forget to check the link in the video description to order the Sigma Phoenix from, and don't forget to also leave a like on this video if you enjoyed the video. Also subscribe to Audiophile Heaven for more awesome content, for more awesome videos, for more awesome time with me. I hope you have the loveliest of weeks in there, and I hope to see you really, really soon. Bye bye. Don't even really know what size this is. 2 millimeters, 1.5.